So I've been on a bit of a break from F1 Ranked the past month or so. I'm honestly not too sure how long it's been. Not long enough. F1 Ranked is incredibly damaging to one's mental health. But with the announcement of F1 24, I need to get some practice in, so I am making a return to F1 23 Ranked. And today I'm going to be looking at my first ranked race back after several months out. So let's get straight into it. This is my qualifying lap for, unfortunately, Miami, a track I absolutely despise, especially the first sector. Coming into turn number one, I missed my braking point by a significant margin, and spoiler alert, this first sector is absolutely diabolical. So that was genuinely my first sector back on F1 23 ranked, and it went horrifically. Who would have guessed? But in the words of a 2012 and ego-driven Christian Horner,
but then he started coming back.
So despite being 1.1 seconds down on pole at the end of the first sector, we're going to finish the lap qualifying P4 and somehow only 4 tenths off pole position. So with the exception of the first sector, we clearly have pace over everyone else at this track. So it's 5 lights and away we go. It's a predictably pretty mediocre start. Coming into turn number 1, that's basically my line in qualifying. You know what, mate, we've all been there. Unlike my qualifying lap, sector 1 was pretty uneventful at the start of the race, but as we head down towards turn number 11, we're under pressure from Thunderbolt. He doesn't go for a dive up or inside, thankfully. As we come through this twisty section at the end of sector 2, we're stuck behind Dyname into the chicane. Obviously, it's not really an overtaking opportunity at this spot. We kind of have to wait for the straight. Try and get a good exit out of this corner, unlike Dyname, and thanks to that, it's going to be a very easy move with the help of ERS, pull alongside him, up into P3. At least it would be an easy move for P3, except this straight is so unbelievably long. Down towards the hairpin, Dyname gets back past us. We try and get a cutback on him, but Thunderbolt hits the back of us, preventing us from doing so. Thunderbolt, luckily, is able to pull into the pit. Now we're going to have to battle Dyname down towards turn number 1. Using the ERS, we're going to have a think at the inside of turn number 1. And no, we're not going to have a think, we're just going to go for it. Whack the side of him, and quite deservedly so. Spin out. I tried going for the Verstappen tactic of if you don't move, we're going to crash into each other. Dyname called my bluff, and as I said, deservedly so, I spin out. Now we're stuck behind this guy for P5, once again through the chicane. I'm hoping this will actually be an easy move this time, because this guy is incredibly slow, at least through the corners. I decide not to use ERS because I'm clearly that confident I'm going to be able to pass this guy alongside him, and I think we're going to stay alongside him down towards the hairpin. Nope, I'm going to be a pussy about it and not go for the move. Clearly a bit scarred from what happened at turn 1. Lap number 3 now. Obviously, last lap, sector 1 didn't go too well. But let's see if I can make some progress. We do get through sector 2 cleanly. We're going to have to see if we can make it to turn 4 without spinning on the next lap. But that spin means we are now behind Sam for, annoyingly, P6. We've got DRS on him and Slipstream. We're significantly quicker than him. We try and go on the outside at turn number 11. He pushes us off wide and then cuts us off. Fair enough, I didn't really think the move was on. And for the third time in a row, I'm stuck behind someone slow through the chicane. Once again, we're going to try and get a good exit at turn number 16, pass him into the hairpin and hopefully drive off in to the distance.
You boxed at the VSC, no?
Whoa.
Yeah.
Oh my god!
Now, you may wonder why I've taken a break from F1 Ranked. Hopefully after seeing that clip, you're not wondering. When I say that was completely unprovoked, you're probably not going to believe me. You're probably going to think I just cut out the bit where I did something to him. Maybe I just went for a questionable move into turn 1 again. It's something I do apparently this race. I'm going to speed up every interaction I had with this guy, and there was very little interaction because the only interaction I had with him was when I spun. I spawned back on track directly behind him. Now, I don't want to blame anyone in this incident. You know, it could be his fault, it could be my fault. He could have just misjudged his braking. I could have just been looking at the apex ahead of me. But it doesn't matter what I think post-race, really. It matters what I thought in the moment. I wanted him dead. I genuinely wanted to fucking kill him. In-game. Okay, so we have a new objective this race. Fuck the result. We just want to beat this guy. If we can take him out and humiliate him at the same time, absolutely perfect. ERS and DRS down towards the hairpin. Go to the right, fake to the left, and we're going to drive right into the side of him and push him as wide as we can. Try and push him against the barrier. Get a 5-second penalty. Completely worth it. Rejoin track, and luckily the AI is going to perfectly drive us into the pit. We're going to serve a 5-second penalty, get a new front wing, serve our pit stop, and we're going to go for an undercut. Let's see if we can make it work. So with the 5-second penalty and the wing change, we've actually got quite a bit of time to just sit and chill. So I'm going to take the opportunity to tell you to subscribe if you're enjoying this video. See? Time to spare as well. So my only focus now this race was to beat the Sam guy, whatever his name is. Not this guy. This is the Sam guy. He's pretty twitchy in a straight line. Hopefully we just get past him as quickly as possible. DRS up the inside into turn number 12. He's not going to cause us too much issues, I don't think. Ignore what I just said. By this point, I was driving on pure anger and emotion. All I wanted to do was beat this Sam guy. That's all I cared about. I was 30 seconds down on him currently at the end of lap number 5. And my anger actually showed in the form of a fastest lap of the race. Clearly, I should drive angry more often. Come to the end of lap number 7, you can see in the top left, Sam is in the pit currently. Have we done enough to jump him, to undercut him? We're going to be on old mediums at the end of this race, but I don't care as long as we beat Sam. Crossing the line, and yeah, we've quite easily jumped him in the pit because he's a shit driver. So it wasn't actually a challenge at all. Lap number 11, and I'm riding high on beating Sam. We've got a 5-second lead on him. He does have softs, but I'm pretty confident I can keep him behind if he does catch up, which he's not going to because he's shit. However, I do have Darth Edge behind me, who is admittedly a little bit quicker than me. I managed to get him out of my DRS down the main straight, but at least I'm going to have a battle to the end of the race. I did have a ghost car ahead of me, and I decided to not actually overtake it through sector 1, and actually sit behind it to get DRS on the second DRS straight. Mainly because I knew Darth Edge slightly had the pace on me, and he had fresher tyres obviously, so I needed everything I could down the straights, because I'm pretty sure he was quicker in a straight line, but I was quicker in the corners. Would it be the right decision? Let's find out as we go through P4 to take P4, but our main focus obviously is on Darth Edge. He's going to look to the outside at turn number 11, side by side, and I did think about letting him pass just so I could beat Sam, but I thought, fuck it, let's fight for it. We have 2 laps left and a straight, and it was getting to that point in the race where we're figuring out where we want to be. Do we want to be behind or ahead? Coming on to the last lap, we're going to use a little bit of ERS to see what Darth Edge does. He goes to the outside of the hairpin, and it's a pretty easy move. There's not a lot I could have done to defend that. Not that I really wanted to, coming onto the penultimate lap of the race. With his better tyre life, I did fully expect him to run away, especially through the first sector. But as we come on to the second DRS straight, I just about hold on to DRS, and that's when I realised I'm still in this. So with a comfortable 5-second gap to Sam, the car we really care about, we are going to be challenging Darth Edge for the rest of this race for P4. We're going to sit behind him as we go through the chicane section, and ideally sit behind him for most of the final lap, and obviously overtake him down towards the hairpin. Obviously, he has the same idea. He's going defensive down the straight, but really, it's very difficult not to overtake someone in that scenario. We are going to be leading into the hairpin. We try and invite him up the inside. He doesn't go for it. So with 2 DRS straights remaining, hopefully he passes us at one of them. Clearly he's been paying attention to what I've been doing, because coming down towards turn number 1, he's obviously got DRS and he goes for a very similar dive to what I did earlier on in the race. But this time, muscles his way through, I'm pretty sure overtakes me illegally off track, but does get the move done. But that actually puts us in prime position to take P4 from him. Obviously we're going to catch him down this straight, and I'm pretty sure he's easing off a little bit because I'm catching him incredibly fast. We're going to look to the outside, but we're obviously not going to go for the move. But this is where the games start. You can see he's running wide, and basically lets me through. I kind of don't have any choice because I really don't want Sam to catch on to us. I will happily sacrifice this P4 if it means beating Sam. Running through turn number 16, I run wide and try and line up the inside line to ruin his run or exit. Out of the corner, it doesn't really work. He ruins my run instead. We're going to use all our ERS on the exit, obviously. But it's going to be difficult to defend against this one. He's looking to the inside. We're going to cut across him very aggressively. I did feel a bit bad about that. And I go to the outside of the hairpin. I do let him through, try to get the cut back. But admittedly, I'll accept P5. That was a fucking disgusting move from me. I think that was the anger that Sam had caused earlier coming out. But we come in P5. The important thing, we beat Sam. And that is where my priorities lie. Immediately upon finishing the race, I knew what I had to do. You are